Hi, my name is Anwar. I'm a designer, a developer, and a teacher at Treehouse. My pronouns are he, him. In this course, we're going to learn the basics of CSS, one of the core technologies for designing and building websites and applications. No matter what kind of website or web application you want to build, you'll have to use CSS. If you haven't written much CSS, or even if you've never written CSS at all, don't worry. That's what this course is for. We'll start with basic CSS concepts, then gradually progress to more advanced topics and lessons. But before diving into CSS, it's important to have a basic understanding of HTML and the structure of a document. If you're not familiar with HTML, go through our HTML courses first, then meet me right back here in CSS Basics. So what exactly is CSS, and why is it considered a core web technology? CSS stands for Cascading Style Sheets and is a style sheet language used to describe the presentation of web pages. As you might have learned in previous courses, a web page is made up of three different layers that work together to deliver an experience to the user. There's a content layer, a presentation layer, and a behavior layer. The content layer is HTML, the structural foundation or outline of a web page. Content like headings, paragraphs, bulleted lists, links, and images are marked up by our HTML. The behavior layer is normally handled by JavaScript, which provides real-time user interaction. And CSS is what handles the presentation layer of a web page, controlling the appearance of our HTML. We use our style sheets to style the HTML with colors, font sizes, backgrounds, layout, and much more. CSS also allows us to adapt our content to various devices, screen sizes, and resolutions. As we move forward, you'll learn strategies for keeping these three layers separate from each other: HTML for content, CSS for style, JavaScript for behavior. Back in the days before CSS was introduced, developers would have to embed presentational tags and attributes in the HTML to control the design of a web page. While it's technically still possible, you'll want to keep your structure and presentation separate. There are two important reasons for this. Writing semantic HTML means choosing the right element for the job. When choosing an HTML element, it's important to ask yourself, what purpose does this content have, not what should this content look like? Proper semantic HTML will make your content more meaningful, more accessible, and easier to find using a search engine. HTML was never intended to be a presentational language, so defining presentation in the HTML creates an inefficient workflow. Imagine having to manually edit tens or hundreds of HTML files to make a styling change. CSS makes the development and maintenance of websites more efficient because the styles written in a single style sheet can be shared across multiple web pages. A change to one CSS file, such as adjusting the background color, can be reflected on all pages of your website or app. And what's exciting is that CSS continues to evolve. Sophisticated visual effects like rounded corners, text and box shadows, gradients, and even animations have been built into CSS for some time. CSS also includes multi-column layouts, grids, and flexbox designed to keep your layouts flexible and legible across a variety of screens and devices. As new technologies arrive, CSS will continue to add features to help you meet the latest challenges. It's a great time to be learning CSS.